Welcome to the Academy, a series focused on the basics of Star Wars The Old Republic. Although Star Wars The Old Republic does not support controllers by default, many clever players have figured out that there are ways to set up the game to be playable on a controller. In this video, we'll be going over how to map your controls for The Old Republic to an Xbox controller if you're playing Star Wars The Old Republic through Steam. If you're playing off of Steam, for example, you downloaded the game from SWTOR.com, I have a separate guide that walks you through how to use Xpadder to play with an Xbox controller instead of using Steam. Let's start with talking about how many abilities and keybinds you have in Star Wars The Old Republic. If you take a look at your abilities bar on a high-level character, it's pretty clear that combat was designed for a keyboard rather than a controller, which is why a controller is not usually recommended for this game. With that said, I'm making this guide before the 7.0 expansion called Legacy of the Sith, which is meant to be released at the end of 2021. And at that point, there's a good chance you'll have even less abilities to keep track of after the expansion launches. Even though this game was designed for a mouse and keyboard, playing with a controller is a great way to work around different disabilities that make using a keyboard difficult or even impossible. And on top of that, some players will simply enjoy playing games with a controller more, especially if they're transitioning over from an Xbox or other console to more traditional computer gaming. One misconception players have is that due to the number of abilities in the game, it's impossible to play Star Wars The Old Republic on a controller, and this is so far from true, and it's a lie that I've been told this entire time I've been playing. It makes me really cranky. With this guide, you'll be able to set up over 55 different keybinds on your Xbox controller, which should cover every single one of your abilities and anything else you want to keybind in the game. So go grab your controller and let's go! Step 1. Open Steam in Big Picture. So when you have Steam open on your computer, open it up in Big Picture mode by clicking the small symbol of a box with two expanding arrows located on the top right. You'll only have controller support while playing in Big Picture mode, so make sure next time you play Star Wars The Old Republic on your controller, open Big Picture first, then open the game. Sometimes Steam has controllers turned off by default, so we need to make sure Xbox controllers are turned on. In Steam Big Picture, click the gear icon for settings on the top right, then choose controller settings from the menu. Lastly, in this new area, make sure Xbox configuration support is checked. If you don't have this checked, you'll get an error message later that says configuration support disabled. Step 3, set up your controller. So you can either do this wired or wirelessly depending on the controller that you have. Most newer Xbox controllers, including even some of the Xbox One ones, have a Bluetooth adapter available for them. So you can either plug it in to your computer using a micro USB cord. It'll have a USB plug in one end and a tiny micro plug on the other. It'll rumble once it's successfully plugged into your computer. The other way is wirelessly using Bluetooth. So the steps to do this are: you need to plug in the Bluetooth dongle into your computer, make sure your computer's on, turn on your controller by holding down the Xbox button in the center, and then here's the tricky part, you're going to hold down the tiny Bluetooth Wi-Fi looking button on the top of your controller, which should make the Xbox button glow on and off very quickly. To get it to pair up with your computer, on your computer, left-click the tiny taskbar arrow near your clock on the bottom right of your screen. Then, left-click the Bluetooth devices icon, which is a little blue oval with a white squiggle in it, and choose Show Bluetooth Devices. If your Xbox controller is not on there, choose Add Bluetooth or Other Devices at the top. From the next window, choose Bluetooth. If your Xbox controller shows up, choose it, and you're good to go. If it doesn't show up, it's not being detected and you'll need to do further troubleshooting than I can help with. If you happen to take too long, like you have trouble finding that window, and your Xbox controller's light is not blinking fast anymore, hold the tiny Bluetooth Wi-Fi button on the top down again on your controller until it blinks fast again. It might still show up on the list, but it will get stuck on connecting if the light isn't blinking fast. Step 4, set up your controller. In Steam Big Picture's main page, click Library, then find Star Wars The Old Republic. Once there, choose Manage Game on the left, then choose Controller Configuration from the menu. Step 5, create a configuration for your Xbox controller. Once your controller is plugged in or connected, you can create a layout for your controller. Steam will start you off with a default configuration. It'll be called Keyboard, WASD, and Mouse at the top. On this menu, you can select a section, then select a button, and assigned it to a key on your keyboard, and map it too. You can create your own keybinds, or I have created my own Star Wars The Old Republic Xbox One controller configuration that you can use to save time. To use my configuration, I have put the actual link to the configuration in the description of this video, or you can try and find it this way. Choose Browse Configs at the bottom, choose Community from the menu on the left, and you'll need to look for mine. It will say my name, Swtorista, in it, and choose it. I have no idea if it's going to show up in that list or not. Once you choose it, it'll look like this. How exactly you want to set up your keybinds is going to be personal preference, but I'm going to show you player Nikolai's setup that was recommended to me. Nikolai has the right click at right button, better known as the right shoulder or right bumper button, due to the camera movement in the game. You need to hold right click to turn your camera and make it as easy as possible. Nikolai assigned it to the button where you normally rest your finger on the top right of the controller on right button. So it will feel fairly natural for most people. The other three top buttons, so right trigger, left trigger, and left bumper or shoulder, Nikolai assigned to Shift, Alt, and Control, which will allow you to use the Shift, Alt, and Control buttons combined with another button to get combination keybinds very similar to what experienced players use on a mouse and keyboard. Nikolai next keybound the D-pad on the left and the lettered keys on the right to the number keys, which are used for both conversation choices and for combining with the Shift, Alt, and Control keys for ability keybinding. For getting around, Nikolai uses the left stick for movement and tapping it for tab targeting, and uses his right stick for moving the mouse cursor and tapping it for what would be left clicking on the mouse. Lastly, Nikolai also keybound the Options button on the right to be the Escape button on the keyboard. At this point is probably a good point for you to be able to try out using your controller in-game and see if it is working. You'll be able to know right away if it's working or not, because once you're actually in-game past the login screen, you'll be able to use your right stick to be able to move your mouse around in-game. If this is not working, but you did successfully follow the other steps, this is the frustrating part. This is where the bugs come in, I guess you could say. About half the time for me, it just worked. And about half the time, it just didn't work. So when it didn't work, here are the steps I took to try and fix it. I don't know what the actual issue is, and I don't know which of these actually fixed it. So I exited out of the game when I realized it wasn't working. I went to the homepage of Big Picture Steam and went back to the controller settings for all of Steam, not just for SWTOR. And to that page where you could turn on Xbox configuration support, I turned everything off, turned PlayStation configuration support on, then turned it off and turned on Xbox configuration support. Then I selected my Xbox controller at the detected controllers list. And then I clicked on identify, which made my little controller rumble. Then I clicked calibrate and okay. As far as I can tell, one of these fixes the issue, but I don't know which. Good luck. I can't really help much more than that if it isn't being properly detected in game. So if you're able to use your controller in Steam, Big Picture, but not in Star Wars The Old Republic, you're experiencing the same issue as I am. If you can't use your controller even in Steam Big Picture, then you have a problem from earlier on in the steps, in that your controller is probably not being detected by your computer at all. Number 6. Keybinds. Once you have decided what you want each of your controller keys to correspond with on a normal keyboard, you can set your keybinds in-game. Once again, to save you a ton of trouble, I've set up a keybind file you can download and add to your SWTOR files. Go to the description of this video and go to the website page linked. Right-click the page and choose Save As. It'll look like a bunch of text. You'll need to save it into your SWTOR keybindings folder. This can sometimes be hard to find. Mine is located in my user files, in app data, local, SWTOR, settings, keybindings. It's a bit of a mess, with Swtorista being my username for my computer. And last step, go in-game, press Escape, Preferences, and go into the tab at the bottom called Keybindings Import Export. You should now see the PS4 and Xbox controller keybinds option on the list on the left, then click OK on the bottom right. This keybinds file includes the 1 key, or in our case, the cross or X key to be jump, strafing for left and right, adding Control plus W for forward and Control plus S for backwards, and rebinding Tab to K so we don't accidentally tab out of the game. Number 7, the user interface. If you're using the full power of keybinds, you'll likely want to have all your quick bars showing now that you have all the keybinds ready to go. You have two options. The first is to use a preset user interface, which is the quickest. To make all your quick bars show, which is 3 for free to play, 5 for preferred players, and 6 for subscribers, to set it up, you'll go into the user interface. editor, either by pressing Escape on your keyboard or going there through the Settings menu at the top of the screen. From there, look for a drop-down at the top and choose Extended Quick Bars. Then click the very small load icon beside the drop-down. If you want something a little more condensed, I've created a user interface with all keybinds for the Xbox together. If you want to use mine instead, you'll need to download my XML file. Very similar steps, so first go to the website that I've linked in the description of this video. It's gonna look like a bunch of text. Second, right-click the page and save as. Third, you'll need to save it in your SWTOR GUI profiles folder. This can also sometimes be hard to find. It'll be in a similar spot. Mine's located in my user files, app data, local SWTOR settings, GUI profiles, with Swtorista being my username for my computer. And lastly, go in game, press escape, or get to the user interface editor again. And then my interface called PS4 and Xbox controller UI should be on the drop-down list. So you can select it and then click the load button on the right of the drop-down. Step 8, figuring out your abilities. The last step is to add your abilities to your quick bars. Which keybinds you want to associate with which abilities is completely up to you. Players tend to put their most used abilities on the 2, 3, 4, 7, 8, 9, and 0 keys, and then go from there for the keybinds that require combinations. With 3 keybind combinations for very obscure abilities or fun abilities like mounts or pets or maybe your map, as no matter what class you are playing, you will not need all 55 keybinds available for combat. To add abilities to your quick bar, you can either press P on your keyboard or choose abilities from the main menu under the icon of a person. From there, you can left-click drag your abilities into the slots on your quick bar. So if I put my ability on the slot that says S plus C plus 3, that short form for Shift plus Control plus 3 key on the keyboard, which for us will translate to right trigger button, left button, bumper, shoulder, plus A on your Xbox controller. It will take a bit of time to memorize where on the controller Shift, Alt, and Control are, but once you have that, you don't need to memorize your abilities right away as you consult your keybinds on your quick bars in their short form if you forget which ability is on which keybind. And lastly, step 9, movement. Once you've got everything set up, you can jump in-game through Big Picture and start playing. Start by using the left stick to move left and right, forward and back with your left thumb. You'll notice you won't be able to look around, just move. To look around and add more nuance to your gameplay, try holding down right button, aka your right bumper or right shoulder, and at the same time wiggle your right stick around so you can do things like look at the sky. Combining all three of these so you can look around while moving is what will give you almost as much versatility when it comes to movement as a player who has a mouse and keyboard. You'll notice in the video I'm actually kind of struggling a lot with moving my camera around. It's moving around too fast. This is a very common issue. This is something that you can change by adjusting the sensitivity of your right stick when it comes to your mouse. And the way you do this is you go back to your Steam Big Picture, you go to your library, go back to Star Wars The Old Republic, go to Manage Game, and then go back into controller configuration, and this is something you're going to customize. So you're going to, if you're using my pre-made configuration, go to joystick mouse, left click, it'll be on the kind of bottom right of the screen, and you'll be able to adjust the mouse sensitivity. This will make it a bit slower moving your mouse around, but it'll help a lot when it comes to adjusting your camera. So let's give this another shot. And so I turned it down really low. I turned it down to about 10 to 20%, and I can now move my camera around without having it flick all over the place. So it's a really great thing that you might want to update. To click things, just use the right stick to move the mouse around. Your left click is going to push the right stick, and to right click things, tap right button your shoulder or your bumper with your right index finger. Most things in the game are activated by right clicking them. Once you find some enemies, push your left stick to tab target them, which means you can click it again to cycle between multiple enemies. You can then use the D-pad on the left and the A, B, X, Y keys on the right to use your attacks. And once you feel comfortable moving around, attacking and targeting, you can start using these combination keys for your other attacks too. If you're struggling to remember, I've made a PDF you can print out that you can tape to the wall or keep beside you as you play that has each of the Xbox controller keybinds on it and labeled. I've linked this printable PDF in the description of this video. As someone who primarily uses a mouse and keyboard and has never owned a console, I was surprised how easy gaming with the controller and these keybinds was. I actually struggle a lot with the types of keybinds that skilled players in the Old Republic use for combat with a mouse and keyboard. They actually use the same key combinations with Alt, Shift, and Control, and the numbers 0 through 9, but because they're so much further spread across the keyboard, I found it a lot easier to combine keybinds on the Xbox controller than I ever have been able to use on a traditional keyboard. Nikolai, who is slightly handicapped and who showed me how to set this up, says he has been able to tank some of the most difficult content in the game using this setup, including Nightmare Mode operations. And I'm not surprised that a skilled player could use this setup for difficult content based on my testing. While someone who is used to a mouse and keyboard may take a while to get used to it, players who are already comfortable using an Xbox or other console controller should be able to pick SWTOR up very quickly once it's all set up. And using a controller where the controls are more condensed and portable definitely gives a lot more options when it comes to accessibility. Before I leave you off with this video, I'm going to give you a super fun fact. I actually found a written guide all the way back from 2011 at the launch of the game where a player showed how they play Star Wars The Old Republic with X-Padder and a controller even before the game came out on Steam. So while Steam makes things easier to set up, playing with a controller is nothing new to the game. I hope you enjoyed this in-depth video guide about how to play Star Wars The Old Republic on an Xbox controller using Steam. I actually will be doing guides as well for doing it off of Steam, as well as on a PS4 controller. It's a very similar kind of process for all of those. If you use this guide to set everything up, I would love to hear your feedback or any suggestions that you have in the comments below. Or if you're a veteran player like me who's been tricked into thinking that you can't play Star Wars The Old Republic in the controller, please also let me know in the comments below. Make me feel not alone. If you want to show your support for these in-depth guides about your favorite video game, please visit swtorista.com/support. Or if you want to have a similar video show up on your YouTube homepage, subscribe to this channel. As always, may the Force and the controller be with you.